So indices for two today we are doing six sums from Selina. So the first sum is you have to simplify this equation. So whenever this type of things are coming, you see that all are the multiples of three, and you should divide any composite numbers into prime number. The basic rule is that you have to divide the numbers into prime numbers, factorization format. So you divide them with prime numbers format. So this is necessary for doing this. So you know 9 is a composite number, it is not a prime number. So 9 can be written as 3 square. So if 27s are there, so that can be written as 3 cube, like that. So first of all, you have to divide each number into its prime format. So if it is originally there like 3, so you don't need to do that. But for 9, you have to break it into 3 square like that. And you know the power to the power will be multiplied. So here also 9 is there. So 9 is written as 3 square like that. Okay. So 3 into 3 to the power. So now whenever there is a multiply application sign, you know that the basic formula for a to the power m into a to the power n is a to the power m plus n. So this formula and power. So the two most important formula are generally used are, one is a to the power m into a to the power n, that is a to the power m plus 1. So this formula and the power formula, a to the power m to the power n is a to the power m into n or n into m, anything. So these are the two fundamental or the most important formula used in the indices problems. So you have to remember this. From this side to that side or the opposite, or we are actually doing according to the need of the sums. So now what happens? We are using this formula, multiplication formula. So it will be 3 into 3 to the power, power multiply. So 2 multiplied with n plus 1. So it will be 2n plus 2 like that. In this case, the say first formula, that is m plus n. So it will be 3 square plus 2n like that. Divided by, this should be the first formula. So it will be 1. Anything, nothing is there means 1 is there. So 2n plus 3. And that will be also multiplied. So it will be 2n plus 2. So now you have to think that this will become how much? So 2n plus 2. 2n plus 2. So this is there. So that means this should be taken as common. So it will be 3 to the power 2n plus 2 will be taken as common. So if it is taken as common, so whole thing comes out. So only there is 3. So it will be 3 minus sign, this minus sign, minus 1. And for this, this is 2n plus 4. So from which you are taking common 2n plus 2. So if you take it as common, so what will remain? So there will remain 2n plus 4 minus 2n minus 2. So that means it is only 2 minus 1. So this 3 to the power 2n plus 2 will be cancelled out. So here it will be 3 minus 1 is 2, and 3 square is 9 minus 1. That is 8. So the answer is 1 by 4. So this is the first answer. Not tough. If you practice, it is not tough. So in this case, what we can do? So you know what is 225? 225 is 15 square. 15 square is 225. So that means 15 is again divided into 3 into 5. So that means 2 to 5 is actually 3 square into 5 square. So that means instead of 2 to 5, we can write it as 3 square into 5 square. Like that. Simple. Now compare the power of 3 and that of 5 in the both case. So if you compare the power of 3, comparing the power of 3. Power of 3 in both sides. So what we get? We get x minus 1. In the left hand side, the power of 3 is x minus 1. So x minus 1 should be equal to the power of 3 in the right hand side. So it is 2. So from that, you got x equals to 2 plus 1, that is 3. So this is the first answer. X equals to 3. Now for the second case, what we have to compare? The power of 5. Same thing. Compare the power of 5. So if you compare the power of 5, then what you got? You got, in this case, what is the power of 5? It is 2y minus 3. So 2y minus 3 should be equals to 2. 5 square. So that means what? 2y should be equals to 2 plus 3, that is 5. So y equals to how much? Y equals to 5 by 2. So that is the answer for the second. That is the solve. Y is 5 by 2, or you may write it as 2.5 or 2.1 by 2, anything. So that answer is x is 3 and y is 5 by 2. So this is the two answer. Okay, easy. Compare only. So any
yes,
number
sir.
can given. So instead of this is 2 to 5, they may be given as something else. So they may be given as what? Like that. And they can change this number also. So it may be but 9:36. So they may given it as like 441. Okay. And it should be 3 to the power. The question may come 2x minus 6 into 7 to the power y by 2. Like that. This sum may come. So tum isko solve karo. कि देखो सॉल्व करके एक्स और वाई का क्या वैल्यू आता है. सो दिस इज द टेस्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. सो प्रैक्टिस इट. सो दिस इज द टेस्ट क्वेश्चन. ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई. सॉल्व फॉर दिस सम. 3 टू द पावर 2x माइनस 6 इनटू 7 टू द पावर y बाय 2 इक्वल्स टू 441. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई. ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट. So 3 to the power 2x minus 6 into 7 to the power y by 2 is given as 441. So try to find out what should be the value of x and y. So try to find out what is how 441 can be written in this fashion. 2 to 5
441,
3 square and 7 square. So 3 square into 7 square. So that means what? The power of 3 in the left hand side is 2x minus 6. So 2x minus 6 equals
four,
to 2. So x will be equal to 4. Similarly, y by 2 is also 2.
Yes.
So y is 4. So x
so y is 4.
And y equals to 4 is the required answer. Now the third sum. 9 to the power n, 3 square, 3 to the power n, and like that, and you have to find it out as 3 to the power minus 3 given. So that m minus n equals to 1. How to break them into a prime number format? So always break them into prime numbers. So this is the basic rule. So break them into prime numbers like that. So if you break them into prime numbers, so 9 is written as 3 square, power is n, so it will become 3 to the power 2n. into 3 square into 3 to the power n minus 27. 27 is 3 cube, so it will be 3 to the power n. And that divided by what? 3 to the power m, like that. So do it. So do it by yourself. So if you break them, that will be ultimately come. Do it yourself. So now, since 3 to the power 3 and 3 square minus 1 is how much? So it will actually become 3 to the power 3 n minus 3 to the power 3 m into 3 square is 9. 9 minus 1 is 8. And 2 cube is also 8. So 8 weight will get cancelled because we are doing this part first. So doing this part, a to the power m, same formula, a to the, this is 3 is acting as m, and m is 3n and n is 3m. So a to the power, the formula is what? You try to find, know the formula. The formula for a to the power m divided by a to the power n is a to the power m minus n. You must remember this. Opposite of multiplication is division. So that's why it is subtracted. So you see that the power of 3 in both the case must be equal. So in this, the left hand side, the power is 3 to the power 3n minus 3m, and in the right hand side it is minus 3. So they must be same. So comparing this power of 3, we can write 3 gets common. So n minus m should be equals to minus 3. So m minus n will be what? Or n minus m will be minus 3 by 3, so that is minus 1. So it is cancelled out, so it becomes minus 1. So if it is minus 1, so if you change the side or multiply both sides by minus 1, it should be m minus n equals to 1, and that is the desired answer. So by this way, you can solve this type of sums. It seems initially it seems complicated, but actually it is not so. Just go with the simple steps and with the formula, and you can easily find out what they are asked to prove. So 3n minus m is equal to minus 3. You divide both sides by 3, so you got n minus m equals to minus 1. So you shift or multiply both sides anyway with minus 1, so you got the value. So this is how you can do this type of sum. Now the fourth sum. Fourth sum, they are given you, if m is cube root of 15, n is cube root of 14, you have to find out the value of m minus n minus 1 by m square and this. So you can see there are the different technique by you can do these sums. One way is think that 1 can be written as what? Why they are given here it is 1, or it may given 1 more than 1, 2 or like that. One technique is, you see that what is m? M is cube root of 15, so what is m cube? So m cube will be cube root of 15's cube. M is cube root of 15, so m cube is what? Cube root of 15, so that means it should be 15. So you got the value of m cube as 15. Similarly, if you do the same way, you got n cube is what? N cube is cube root of 14's cube. So it is 14. So what is the value of then m cube minus n cube? m cube minus n cube is what? 15 minus 14. So 15 minus 14 equals to 1. So now what is the formula for m cube minus n cube? You know the formula for m cube minus n cube. Formula for m cube minus n cube is m minus n, then m square plus mn plus n square, like that. So m minus n, m square plus mn plus n square equals to 1. So if you divide both sides with m square plus mn plus n square, what you got? You got m minus n should be equals to 1 by m square plus mn plus n square. Now you shift the side, then you got m minus n minus 1 by m square plus mn plus n square, and here it will remain as 0. So by this technique you find the value of m square plus n square. Hello, m square plus,
yes, sir.
M square plus m, so this is the question. By this technique you can do. So try to remember the formula and proceed this way so you can get. So this is the formula for m cube minus n cube, because you see that m cube minus n cube is 15 minus 14. So if you subtract them, so you got m cube minus n cube as 1, like that. So by this way you can do. Another way is just doing the LCM method. So this is another method. If you don't do this type of technique, you can go with the LCM method. So what is the LCM method then? So with LCM method, what the whole thing's LCM will be, what LCM will be? M square plus mn plus n square, like that. And here it will be what? M into this means m minus n. Think m minus n as a block. Think this as a block, because both of them are nearly same, because they have the same denominator, 1. So think them as one block. So it is, let it be a. So a by 1 by a, like that type of sums. So it will be what? A into this thing. So A into the LCM, that is m square plus mn plus n square and minus 1 for this one. So m minus n into m square plus mn plus n square is what? You have to know the formula. So it will be what? It will be m cube minus n cube. So it is m cube minus n cube, and then this minus 1, and that is divided by m square plus mn plus n square. Don't put the value of m and n in the denominator. If you do that, that will complicate the sums. So by doing this, now it is, you know that m cube and n cube is 15 minus 14 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So you know the 0 by something is actually 0. The answer will be 0 in the both the case. So by this way also you can do the sums. Now the fifth sum, that is 2 to the power n, 6 to the power n plus 1, like that. And you have to find or evaluate, which means it gives a value. So the basic rule is the same. You have to put all the number into prime format. 2 is a prime number, so don't change it. But 6 is not prime, so 6 will be written as 2 into 3. This is the technique by which you can do this kind of sums. So m plus 1 it multiply with 10. 10 is also a composite number, so 10 is the product. Write that all the number into the product format of prime number. So 10 is 2 into 5, and there its product is m minus n. Now 15, you know, 15 is 3 into 5. So like that. And it will be m plus n minus 2. Similarly, for the denominator also, write it this way, same way. So 4 is 2 square and the power is m, so it will be 2 to the power 2m. 3 is actually prime number, don't need to break it down. But 25 is not a prime, so it is 5 square, and that is multiplied with m minus 1, so it will be 2 into m minus 1, so 2m minus 2. Now there are 3 numbers, so try to make these 3 different type of numbers. One type of number is 2, so see that there is one number as to make them different from other. So this is 2, not the power, the base number. So there are 2 as the base number in 4 cases. Now there are another type of numbers like 3. So this is 3 3 3. So there are 3 3 in the sum, and after that there is also another number, that is 5. So there are 3 5 in the sums. So try to make them in a block, means together, make them together. So if you make them together and write their power, so what will you find out? So I write 2 with brown color. So there are 2 to the power n, this. Okay, this is done. So make it right. Then there is this 2. You are dealing with this 2. So here 2 and the power is m plus 1. They in the numerator, so they will be multiplied. 2 to the power m plus 1. Like that. There is another 2 here. So, and what is its power? Its power is m minus 1. And it is also in the numerator, so it will be multiplied. 2 to the power m minus 10. Now there is a 2 in the denominator, so divide this by 2 to the power 2. So all the 2s are actually done. So make it inside a bracket. Or you may directly do it, since it is in the denominator, so it write 2 into 2 to the power minus 2m. But do it in different steps. So that makes you easy to understand. Now there is a number that is 3. So there are how many 3s? 3 3s are there. So what is their power? The first is 3 to the power m plus 1. Second one is 3 to the power m plus n minus 2. Both of them are numerators, so they are multiplied. And there is another 3 which is in the denominator side, that is 3 to the power 2m plus n. So we done with 3. Now there is another number which is 5. So make them in 3 separate way or separate blocks. Better to call them as blocks. So 5m minus n into 5m plus n minus 2, that divided with 5, 2 to the power m minus 2. Bus, we complete the 3 blocks. Now you know the all the numerator which are in the multiplied form, they will be added up. So what will be the power of 2 then? So 2 to the power n plus m plus 1 plus m minus n, and the division will be subtracted, so that's why it is minus 2m. So we are done with 2. Now for the case of 3. same way. 3 will be m plus 1, then multiplication means plus or addition, m plus n minus 2, and division means subtract, 2m minus n. See, now the last one, that is with 5. So for 5, it will be 5 m minus n plus m plus n minus 2 minus, it will be how much? 2m plus 2. Okay. So we are also done with 5. Now just subtract, add and subtract. So you see that this n plus n plus n minus n cancelled out. M plus m is 2m minus 2m. So it will be actually cancelled out. So the power of 2 is become 2 to the power 1. Similarly for 3, this m plus m is 2m and minus 2m cancelled out. Plus n minus n cancelled out. So it will be 1 minus 2. So it will be 3 to the power minus 1 plus 1 minus 2. So it will be 3 to the power minus 1. And what is for 5? For 5, it is
5 to the power
1. N minus plus n minus n cancelled out. Minus 2 plus 2 is also cancelled out. So there is no power left for 5. So it will be 5 to the power 0. So okay. 2 to the power 1 is 2 and 3 to the power minus 1 is 1 by 3. And 5 to the power 0, anything to the power 0 is 1. So that means 2 by 3 is the answer. So by this way you can do this type of sums. And now the last sum. So 6 is evaluate 4, 2 to the power 16, like that. So you have to remember the power format of all the numbers. If you remember the power format of all the numbers, then it is very easy. Otherwise, you have to break this number into the prime format. So if you know that the cube, square, so 6 cube is actually 216. You should remember this type of thing. And 2 to the power 5 is 32, 2 to the power 6 is 64, 2 to the power 7 is 128, and 2 to the power 8 is actually 256. Like that. And what is 243? 243 is 243 is how much? 243 is 81 into 3.
3 to the power of 5.
So it will be 3 to the power 4, 3 to the power 5. So it is 3 to the power 5 is 243. So if you remember these three numbers into the prime format or the power format, because 6 is not a prime number, so then it is become easy. So how we do this sum? So 4, 216 is 6 cube. So that means it will be 6 power multiply 6 cube into minus 2 by 3. Then for 256, it is how much? 2 to the power 8. So it will be 2 to the power 8 into minus 3 by 4. Plus it will be 2 divided by 3 to the power 5 into minus 1 by 5. So now you see that 3 gets cancelled, 4 to the 8, 5 get cancelled. So it actually becomes 4 into 6 to the power minus 2 plus 1 by 2 to the power minus 6 plus 2 by 3 to the power minus 1. So if there is a power, means something to the power minus x to the power minus m 1 by, so that will be x to the power m. So we are using this formula, 1 by x to the power minus m is x to the power m. So that means it will be 4 into 6 square, and you know 6 square is 36, plus 2 to the power 6 is 64, plus 2 into 3, that is 6. So 4 to the power 36 is how much? 144. Because 4 into 30 is 120 plus 24. 120 plus 24 is 144. Plus 64 plus 2, 3 is a 6. So it will become 70. So 70 plus this. So the answer is 240. 214 is the answer. Okay. So by this way, hope you enjoyed today's video. So if you enjoyed the video, please click the like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you.